Hello everyone, this is So Retro, and today I will be showing you everything I know about UFC 5 Online Career Mode. Alright, so starting off, all of your combos are going to begin at 1 star, and as you complete more and more fights, you will grow expertise with your strikes, which will also unlock your combinations, as you can see here. For instance, if you want to increase your traditional combos to 2 star, you will have to reach level 3 for one of the kicks listed below. So I'm still not 100% sure if the expertise increases on strikes landed or strikes thrown. So if you do have information on that, just comment below. Moving on to perks, there's a variety of them. They cost evolution points in UFC 5 Online Career Mode, which is in the top right corner. You gain those as you progress your fighter or level up. If you look to the left side of the screen, you will see that there's 2 slots that you're initially given when you first start off, and then you have 3 extra slots that can be unlocked through prestiging, and then also it may cost some extra evolution points the more spaces that you unlock for more perks to, you know, be equipped to your fighter. Typically I only run 3 because it's free and I'd rather use my evolution points, you know, in other places. Few examples being attribute upgrades, unlocking new moves, which I will be detailing later on in the video, so just stay tuned. Also, if you're like me and like a little balance in your build, you may want to pay attention to the color coding. The red perks are for stand up, the green perks are for health, and the blue perks have something to do with grappling. Alright, so please forgive the order of the video. I had some recording blunders, so I'm kind of all over the place. But in a second here, I'm going to switch over to my main build, the build that I've been using lately. It's a grappling build, but I play it pretty balanced. As you will see, if you stick around to the end of the video, I'm actually going to show a fight that I did and explain my thought process as I progressed throughout the fight. Alright, so this is what I meant by me wanting to utilize my evolution points more so towards my stats, and there's a lot of stats to choose from, so unfortunately you can't max them all out. You kind of have to go either with your playstyle, or if you're just trying to try out a certain playstyle, you'll want to allocate your evolution points towards stats that will make that playstyle beneficial to you. For instance, if you want to be a kickboxer, you know, you're going to want to increase your leg kick speed, your kick power, you know, as well as other factors, but I'm just saying things that more so aligns with the playstyle that you're building. A quick note, I will say you should always look through your moves just to make sure that all the ones that can be equipped are currently equipped. Sometimes the game doesn't equip it from the start. For instance, you're about to see me go through here. Well, no, this is actually on my build, so you won't see it, but sometimes like a elbow or a head kick, you know, like the roundhouse kick, sometimes it won't start off equipped, and it's free, so you just have to go in and equip it yourself, unfortunately. But yeah, just keep that in mind when you're, anytime you reset your build or prestige it, just keep in mind to check all your moves, make sure you have everything that you want and everything that you can have, because why not? Also, if I'm not mistaken, you can earn some of these moves, because sometimes I've had submissions on like a boxer build that I made, and I know I've never spent any evolution points towards it. So yeah, just keep that in mind as well. All right, and then you see here I have a little boxing on my build, because I do, again, I do box. I don't have to resort to spamming people, even with little to no stats in my striking. So the perks I run so far on this build is Wrestle Clinic, which helps me maintain control. It increases my grapple defense whenever I am in top ground position. And then Workhorse, which I mean, it's beneficial all around, but especially for opponents who like to fake escape and then you deny and you lose stamina, more stamina than them. It helps balance that out too. I almost forgot. I'm also going to show you how to buy boost if you want to. Boosts are really beneficial too. I've utilized it a lot since they allowed us to do it now. It really helps you get those evolution points a lot quicker, especially when the competition starts getting steep in the higher divisions and you really need those points to kind of fill out your character. All right, and I hope you don't mind. I kind of sped up this clip because it was taking a little while to get an opponent, but I eventually got one. And real quick before the match starts, I just want to appreciate anyone who's made it this far in the video. This is actually my first commentary, so it's something really new to me. And it's not my best work, but I promise I'm going to get better with time, though. Cool, so we got the glove touch. Working the jab. Straight. And the first round usually isn't my best work. I'm really just trying to see exactly what my opponent's going to throw so I know what to expect the second round where I can really capitalize. Alright, so right now he's piecing me up, which this happens more so than not at the beginning of the round because, again, they have all their stamina, so they have all their stats and whatnot. You see here, I threw a fake attempt first. I pieced him up. Then I threw a real takedown attempt. The initial fake takedown drops his guard because he wants to stop the takedown. And then I pieced him up top, which brought his guard back up, allowing me to get the actual takedown. And now is kind of where I get my best work, you know, with all my stats being mainly towards the ground game and grappling. So my game plan is to kind of beat you up while you're here, drain some stamina by working that body. That way, once I do get up, even though you have the stand-up advantage more than likely with your striking attributes, I still have some weaknesses that I can exploit, like going to your body or maybe your head damage is a little bit higher now once you get up from the ground. It's not always about trying to submit my opponent to get a cheesy victory real early in the fight or spam you while you're on the ground. I fight kind of like a Dagestani with this build, and I mean, it's part of the game, it's wrestling. Alright, so this is the part where I kind of back out of the video. I'm gonna still let the gameplay finish through so that you can see the entire fight and kind of see where my game plan is throughout the fight and see how I'm able to utilize the wrestler and steel strike with some of the best, because I've uploaded clips where I played people who were ranked like number 3 and my striking was almost non-existent, but I was still, you know, banging out with them. So it's really about how good you are at the game and how much time you put in practicing and, you know, just learning everything. But as far as UFC 5 online career mode, I hope I've covered all the bases. I'm sure I haven't, because I still don't know everything about the game. Again, I just gave you all the information that I'm privy to. So I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll catch you in the next one.